In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet using the quadratic formula. And this is going to be using the quadratic formula to solve quadratic equations. Quickly, let's go over the quadratic formula. Well, we know that a quadratic equation is in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c. And when that's equal to 0, we can use the quadratic formula to solve for our variable x. And now here's the quadratic formula for solving for x. X equals the opposite of b, so negative b, plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c. So that's the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac all over 2 times a. So again, the opposite of b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And it's important to note that because this is plus or minus, the majority of the time we will get two separate answers when solving for x. So knowing this, let's look at number 1. In number 1, our variable is m. But we can say that a is equal to 1, since 1 times m squared equals m squared. B is a negative 5, since the 5 is subtracted. And c is a negative 14, since the 14 is subtracted. We're adding bx and adding c, so if we're subtracting b and subtracting c, then they're going to be negative in our formula. Now we're just going to plug in and solve. So m is our variable, so that's going to be equal to the opposite of b, so the opposite of negative 5, plus or minus the square root of b squared, negative 5 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is negative 14, all over 2 times a, which is 2 times 1. Now I'm going to simplify this. So we have the opposite of negative 5, and the opposite of a negative is a positive, so we'll have 5 plus or minus the square root of negative 5 squared is negative 5 times negative 5, which is 25, and we're subtracting 4 times a times c. So 4 times 1 times negative 14 is going to be negative 56, but if we're subtracting a negative 56, that's the same as adding a positive 56, and that's all over 2 times 1, which is 2. Simplifying further, we'll have 5 plus or minus the square root of 25 plus 56, which is the square root of 81, and that's all over 2. Simplifying even further, we'll have 5 plus or minus the square root of 81 is 9, and that's all over positive 2. So we'll have 5 plus 9 over 2 and 5 minus 9 over 2. So let me write out each of those solutions and then we'll simplify them individually. So we have 5 plus 9 over 2 and we also have 5 minus 9 over 2. 5 plus 9 over 2 is going to be 14 over 2. 5 minus 9 over 2 is going to be negative 4 over 2. 14 divided by 2 is 7. And negative 4 over 2 is a negative 2. So you can see that 7 and negative 2 are my solutions for number 1. And I'll write them in set notation. So in order to solve this, m equals 7 and m equals negative 2. When we plug in 7 and negative 2 in for m, we will get 0 when the math is worked out. So let's continue on to number 2. In number 2, a is a positive 1, b is going to be a negative 4, and that's the b in our formula, not the b within our quadratic equation. And then c is a positive 4. So remember, the opposite of b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2 times a. If that gets confusing, refer back to your formula. But a helpful hint is that whenever you're writing it out, just say it to yourself all in one step. The opposite of b plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And just each time you say it, it'll help with remembering it. So we have the opposite of b, so the opposite of negative 4, plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared, so negative 4 squared, minus 4 times a, so 4 times 1, times c, which is 4, all over 2 times a, 2 times 1. So the opposite of negative 4 is positive 4, and we'll have plus or minus the square root. Negative 4 squared is 16, minus 4 times 1 times 4 is 16, and that's all over 2 times 1, which is 2. Now simplifying further, we'll have 4 plus or minus the square root of 16 minus 16 is 0, all over 2. But note that the square root of 0 is simply 0, so we only have one solution, because adding or subtracting 0 to a number will not change the value. So if we have 4 plus 0, that's equivalent to 4 minus 0. So this is just equal to 4 over 2, and 4 divided by 2 is 2. So our solution in number 2 is 2. In number 3, our a value is a positive 2, our b value is a positive 2, and our c value is a negative 12. So remember the formula. The opposite of b plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac all over 2 times a. So the opposite of b, the opposite of 2, plus or minus the square root of b squared, 2 squared, minus 4 times a, 4 times 2, times c, which is negative 12, all over 2 times a, 2 times 2. Simplifying, we'll have negative 2 plus or minus the square root, 2 squared is 4, minus 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times negative 12 is negative 96, so that will be 4 plus 96, and we're dividing that by 2 times 2, which is 4. So that would be negative 2 plus or minus the square root of 4 plus 96, which is the square root of 100, all over 4. And since 100 is a perfect square, we will get negative 2 plus or minus 10 all over 4, since 10 is the square root of 100. And just a quick note that this plus or minus takes care of whether it was 10 squared that gave us the positive 100 or negative 10 squared that gave us the positive 100. So when we're adding, that's like the positive 10 squared, and when we're subtracting, that's like the negative 10 squared that gave us that 100. Now I'll split this up, so we'll have negative 2 plus 10 over 4, and we'll have negative 2 minus 10 all over 4. Negative 2 plus 10 is positive 8 over 4, and negative 2 minus 10 is negative 12 over 4. 8 divided by 4 equals 2, negative 12 divided by 4 equals negative 3. So our solutions in number 3 are 2 and negative 3. In number 4, our a value is positive 2, our b value is a negative 3, and our c value is a negative 5. So x equals the opposite of b, so the opposite of negative 3, plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac. So b squared is negative 3 squared minus 4 times a, 4 times 2, times c, which is negative 5. And that's all over 2 times a, 2 times 2. Simplifying, the opposite of negative 3 is a positive 3, and we're adding or subtracting the square root of negative 3 squared, which is 9, minus 4 times 2 is 8, times a negative 5 is going to be subtracting a negative 40, but as opposed to subtracting a negative, let's just write that as adding a positive 40. And that's all divided by 2 times 2, which is 4. Now, simplifying further, we'll get 3 plus or minus the square root of 9 plus 40, which is 49, all over 4. 49 is a perfect square, so that'll be 3 plus or minus 7 all over 4. So one solution is 3 plus 7 divided by 4, and the other solution is 3 minus 7 divided by 4. 3 plus 7 will be 10 divided by 4, and 3 minus 7 will be negative 4 divided by 4. 10 over 4 can be simplified if we divide both the numerator and denominator by 2, we'll get 5 halves. Negative 4 divided by 4 is simply negative 1. So our solutions in number 4 are a positive 5 halves and negative 1. I think it's important to also think about this visually. If we were to have a graph x and y values, and I'll quickly draw a random quadratic equation, the solutions is when that equation equals 0, which is essentially the x value that crosses the x-axis. That is why a lot of the time we will have two solutions, because that quadratic equation will intersect the x-axis, or the y equals 0 axis, 2 times. And on the occasions where it intersects once, that's usually either a maximum or a minimum. That is why sometimes we only have one solution, whereas most of the time we have two. So again, I just think it's important that in the back of your mind, you're also visualizing what exactly solving a quadratic formula means. Now let's continue on with number 5. In number 5, we have a as positive 1, b as positive 4, and c as positive 3. So x equals the opposite of b, the opposite of 4, plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac. So b squared is 4 squared minus 4 times a times c is 4 times 1 times 3. And that's all over 2 times a, which is 2 times 1. Simplifying, we'll have negative 4 plus or minus the square root of 4 squared is 16 minus 4 times 1 times 3, which is minus 12. And that's all over 2 times 1, which is 2. So we'll have the opposite of 4, or negative 4, plus or minus the square root of 16 minus 12, which is the square root of 4, all over 2. And I know that the square root of 4 will give us a whole number 2. So the opposite of 4, negative 4, plus or minus 2, all over 2. So writing my two separate answers, we'll have negative 4 plus 2 over 2, and we'll have negative 4 minus 2 over 2. Negative 4 plus 2 is a negative 2 over 2, and negative 4 minus 2 is a negative 6 over 2. So that will give us either negative 1 or negative 3 as our solutions. And that's because negative 2 divided by 2 equals a negative 1, and negative 6 divided by 2 equals a negative 3. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 6. However, before I go over the solution to this, please remember to click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Now hopefully that you've done that, let's go over the answer for number 6. Our a value is 2, our b value is 3, and our c value is a negative 20. So for our quadratic formula, x is going to equal the opposite of b plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4 times a times c all over 2 times a. So I plugged in those numbers, and now we'll simplify. The opposite of 3, negative 3, plus or minus the square root of 3 squared is 9 minus 4 times 2 times negative 20. So the square root of 9 minus 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times negative 20 is negative 160. But if we're subtracting a negative, that's the same as adding a positive 160. And that's all over 2 times 2, which is 4. So we'll get negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 9 plus 160, which is 169, all over 4. So that's going to be negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 169 is going to be equal to 13, and that's all over 4. So our two solutions are negative 3 plus 13 divided by 4, and negative 3 minus 13 divided by 4. Negative 3 plus 13 is 10, and we're still dividing that by 4, and negative 3 minus 13 is negative 16, and we're dividing that by 4. 10 fourths can get simplified if we divide both by 2, so both the numerator and the denominator by 2, we'll get 5 halves. And 4 goes into negative 16 evenly, negative 16 divided by 4 is a negative 4. So my two solutions in number 6 are 5 halves and negative 4. So you can think that when that's graphed, our quadratic will intersect the x-axis, or the y equals 0 axis, when x is equal to 5 halves, and when x is equal to negative 4. If you didn't do so already, like, subscribe, and share. Continue on to the next video where I'll go over the next 6 problems on this worksheet, completing numbers 7 through 12.